Hello everyone! Today we are going to see some of the new features inside Adobe Photoshop CC 2017. Alright, fantastic, so let's get to it. Alright, now the first thing that you are going to notice after you open your Adobe Photoshop CC 2017 is this new start workspace that you can see in here, which it will basically show you a list of recently opened files that you've already opened. As you can see in here, Photoshop show me that I already opened these two pictures 30 minutes ago. Now I think this is really cool, but if you want to hide this, you can do that. If I go to this gear icon and one click to it, Photoshop will tell me that I can hide this start workspace under preferences, which I will show you how to do that later. Now in this version we have a new document dialog box too. If I go to this new, or you know, press Ctrl plus N, or go to file and then choose new, a new document box will open, which has also my recent item that I created and several tabs in the top that we'll find in here. A saved custom tab that I can save my custom presets in here, and also photos that it has the default photo preset that come with Photoshop, and the same for print, illustration, web, mobile, and film and video. But I can always create my own presets in the right in here. As you can see, I can create my own width and height if I want. And there's also this advanced option that you will find in here closed. If you open it, you'll find in here you can change your color profile if you want, and also your pixel aspect ratio if you want. Alright, so I'm gonna close this. Also, Photoshop now offers the search command, which basically means that you can now search for an online help if you want, or you can search for a stock image, or you can search directly inside Adobe Photoshop itself. Now if I go to this search in here and one click to it, as you can see, this search will open, which allows me to search for an online help by going to learn or stock if I want to search for an image, or you know, if I want to search inside Adobe itself, I can just select this Photoshop. But if I keep it in all, I can search of course in the three options that I have in here. But in this one, I want to search inside Adobe Photoshop, so I will go and select Photoshop in here, and I will type preferences, because we want to get access in the preferences in here. And as you can see, it will show me all the options that I have in the preferences, or all the options that it will include the word preferences in here. So we want to go to the general preferences. I can get access to this by going to edit and preferences and then general, or you know, I can just press Ctrl plus K. So I'm just gonna one click to this, and as you can see, the preferences dialog will open. Now in these options in here, as you can see, you will find the show start workspace when no documents are open checked. If you don't want to see this new start workspace, you can just uncheck it and you won't see it anymore. Now if you want to go back to the old new documents interface, you can just check this use legacy new document, and this will take you back to the old new document, but I'm not gonna do that. But keep in mind, these changes that you will make in here, it will take effect the next time you will open Photoshop. Alright, so I'm gonna just press cancel. Alright. Now we are going to see the new and improved face aware liquify feature, which basically allows you to edit the shape of person's face along with the mouth, nose and eyes. Now this feature, it first was introduced in Photoshop 2015.5. Now I'm gonna open this image in here, and I will right click and choose convert to smart object. Now we'll go to filter and choose liquify. And as you can see, the Liquify workspace will open in here. Now we are going to see the face aware, which we will find in this property in here. As you can see, if I open this face aware Liquify, we'll have all these options that we can use to make adjustment to all the face features in here. Now as you can see in the eyes, we have the eye size, height, width and tilt and distance, and in the nose the height and width, and the mouth you can make the mouth smile, and we can make adjustment to the upper lip and the lower lip and the mouth width and the height of the mouth too. And also we can adjust the face shape, including the forehead and the chin height and the jawline and the face width. Alright, I'm gonna show you in the eye size in here. I can make the adjustment on each size in this version of Photoshop. Now if I zoom in, I can use this slider to adjust the eye size of this left eyes in here. So I will just make it a little bit bigger, just like that. And as you can see, we have this eyes getting bigger alone, just like that, or smaller. Now I can make the same adjustment to the other eye by going to the right eye in here and make it smaller if I want, or bigger. But if I want to make the same adjustment to each eye, I can just make this link active, and as you can see now I can move this slider and the other one with move too, so I can make this eye smaller, and as you can see the other eye is getting smaller too. Or if I want to work separately on each eye, I can just make this an active, and as you can see now I can make the adjustment to each eye in here. Alright, now I can access to all this option using my mouse key too. So if I go to this face 2 in here and make it active, as you can see I can use all this option using my mouse. As you can see, we have in here these two lines over the face in here, and if I hover into the face, I can see the circles that I can use to make the adjustment to the face shape in here. And if I hover over the eye, I can see all these points that I can use to make adjustment to each eye separately if I want, and the same goes for the nose and the mouth. Now if I hover over this one eye in here, I can see I can make it bigger or smaller using my mouse. As you can see in here, Photoshop show me when I hover over this that I can adjust the eye size if I make it bigger, just like that, if I want, or smaller. Now if I also press shift, I can make the same adjustment to the other eyes, just like that. I'm gonna make some changes in here, and the same goes for the nose. I can adjust the nose height and the nose width, and even for the cheek, if I hover over the cheek, I can see that Photoshop tell me that I can move the cheek, just like that. And the mouth, I can adjust the upper lip and the lower lip too, and even rotate it a little bit, the whole mouth, just like that, and move it just like so. I'm gonna try to make some major changement so we can see the before and after, and I'm gonna move this chin high just like so, and adjust the width of the face and even the forehead, just like that, and I will press OK. Now as you can see, because I converted to a smart object, now I can see in here I have this liquify in here that I can make it active or inactive. Now if I one click to this eye in here, I can see the before I use this liquify, and if I make it active again, I can see the image after I use the liquify. Now we are going to see the enhanced select and mask tool in this version of Photoshop. So we'll open this image in here, and I'm gonna try to cut this image from its background using the select and mask tool, just like a demonstration so we can see how this tool works. So we'll go and choose select, and then select and mask, and as you can see in here we have it in this mode that you can see in here, it's called onion skin. Which we can change it to whatever mode we want to work on in here. So I'm gonna choose this overlay, and as you can see in here I have it in a selected area, which you can change to masked area if you want to work on it, but I prefer to work in a selected area. So I'm just gonna make it like that. And as you can see in the right, in the left in here, we have all these options that now include in the select and mask tool in here, which it was known before as a refined edge, if you were not familiar with it. Now we have all these options. As you can see, we have the quick mask tool in here available, and the refined edge, and also we have the brushes that we can use in here. And in this version of Photoshop, we have the polygonal lasso tool in here and the lasso tool. So I'm gonna use the quick selection tool to make my selection. I'm gonna make it bigger, just like that. I'm gonna make a selection, and as you can see, because I choose the overlay mode in here, it will make my selection like a red color in here, which we use for the quick mask tool, if you are familiar with it. And you can change the color of this selection to whatever color you want, of course, by going to these colors in here and change it to whatever color you prefer to use. I'm gonna use this blue in here, and I will press OK. And I'm gonna make my selection just like that. And I will zoom a little bit. And as you can see, I don't have this selected. Try to make my selection as clean as I can, and as you can see in this area in here, I need to make my selection just like that. Alright, I think it's all covered now. Alright, now I can go and change the view mode if I want. I will change it to on layers in here, and as you can see, I have all these parts selected. Now I can use my refined edge, so I will go and switch to this refined edge in here. And as you can see in here, in this edge detection, I can open it and, you know, check the smart radius. And even in here, I can make the radius a little bit up, around 2 or 3 pixels, just like that, just to help me make the selection a little bit better. So I'm gonna make the hair selection a little bit better, improve it a little bit, just like that. And in here too, I'm gonna just improve the hair selection just a little bit, as you can see. Alright, I think it looks good. Now I'm gonna switch the view mode to this black on white, so I can see my selection even better. As you can see in here, I have this white that I don't want, so I'm gonna use the refined edge, but I'm gonna press Alt, and then I'm gonna try to delete this in here. As you can see, it will do a really good job to delete all this white that we had before. Now I'm gonna change the output mode to layer mask, and I will press OK. And as you can see, we have our selection easily done using the select and mask tool in here. I'm gonna make a new background. I'm gonna choose this gradient and choose this color in here, and I'm gonna make a background just like that to show you the selection. As you can see, it did really a good job making the selection. And there you go. As you can see, this is our the most new feature that you will have in Adobe Photoshop CC 2017. Alright, so I hope that you like and you enjoyed this tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more tutorials to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.